Hello, good morning to everyone. Today, I am going to explain the concept center of mass. In previous video, we discussed about the collisions, types of collisions, coefficient of restitution, and some of the applications regarding to coefficient of restitution and collisions. Now in this class, the current chapter is center of mass. What is center of mass? The point. It is a point where the total mass of a body is concentrated. Suppose, let us have a rigid body. Its entire mass is supposed to be concentrated at one point inside the body. The point is called as the center of mass. Right? Also here, how do you find the center of mass and also what are the concepts regarding this same? Let us hear. It is the first part of mass M1. This is the second part of M2. These two particles form a system. Separation between these two masses is R. Ikkada center of mass of these two particles always lies along the line joining the two particles. And the entire center of mass will be. This is center of mass. Let the distance of center of mass from the center of first body is equal to say this R1. And the initial distance which is R1 will be above the center of mass. About the center of mass, we know M1 R1 is equal to formula M2 R2. About the center of mass, M1 R1 is equal to M2 R2. Or M is proportional to what value? 1/m. That means the center of mass is a point which divides the total length of the two particles in the inverse ratio of the masses. Inverse ratio of the masses, because M is proportional to 1/m. Similarly, in terms of M1, M2 and R, distance of the center of mass from the first particle is given by R1 is equal to M2 into R by M1 plus R. Okay? And distance of center of mass from the center of second body is equal to M1 into R by M1 plus R. M1 into R by M1 plus M. These are R1 and R2 particles. These are the point of mass. Remember this point. R1 is equal to M2 R by M1 plus M2 and R2 is equal to M1 R by M1 plus M2. This example is given already. Let us consider hydrogen chloride. Suppose here, in case of hydrogen HCl, hydrogen and chlorine atoms, this is hydrogen and this is the chlorine. Hydrogen and chlorine atoms, these two are separated by a distance R is equal to some 0.38 angstrom units. 0.38 angstrom units. Find the distance of center of mass from the center of hydrogen and the center of mass of the initial distance center of the calculate change. Given mass of hydrogen is equal to M and mass of chlorine is equal to nearly 36 times that of hydrogen. Okay, na? This is data is the R of the here. Then what is the formula? From this, distance of center of mass from the center of first body is equal to formula M2 into R by M1 plus M. That is equal to M2 is equal to 36 into M into R is equal to 0.8 into angstrom units is equal to actually find the value of R in terms of angstrom units 0.38 by M1 plus M2 is equal to M plus 36 M. So this is equal to 36 M into 0.38 by identical to 37 M. Because M and M match. Okay, 36 into 0.38 by 37 in value solving is the M take and possible. That should be 9 solvings. So this is the procedure to find the distance of center of mass in case of HCl atom from the center of hydrogen. Hydrogen atom is one more. Okay. Right. Next one. Next one. How do you find the center of mass of different bodies? Suppose in case of regular shaped body, center of mass lies at the geometric center. For example, can be in case of a square frame or square plane, center of mass can be the center of mass is lying at the point of intersection of the diagonals. This is the position of center of mass. Okay, na? In case of a equilateral triangular frame, each side is equal to the other. Center of mass is lying at the centroid. It is center of mass. Total height is equal to which and to the total height of center of mass will be divided into ratio 2 is 1. Okay, na? Because your center of mass will be lies at the point of intersection of the nucleus. Okay, ready? Again, in case of rectangular plane, in case of rectangular plane, center of mass is also lying at the geometric center. Ila, for geometric bodies, center of mass is always lying at the geometric center. Next one, in case of individual shaped bodies, and how we find the center of mass? Then, table mundu, some example one. Okay, example this one. Example one lo. Let three particles of masses m1, m2, m3 and m1 equal to m2 equal to m3 is equal to m all have identical masses. If I say neglect the mass of these edges, each side length is equal to m, find the coordinates of center of mass center. Find the coordinates of center of mass center. Center of mass will be lies at the point of intersection of the all the regions. This is center of mass. Okay, na? But find the distance of the center of mass from the any carbon number. Convince the carbon number to see center of mass position characteristic. Yala this is carbon number. Right. Again, here, to find the coordinates of center of mass, let us get one of the particle is an alpha of the coordinate system. This is taken on y axis and this is taken on x axis. Now, this is center of mass coordinate standard. This is first coordinate. M1 is equal to, say, it is 1 kilogram, M2 is equal to 2 kilogram, and M3 is equal to 3 kilogram. Now, we can get different things. Center of mass calculation may be different mass of body, center of mass not twice exactly at the center point. Because there are different masses. Okay. Here is true. Here the coordinates of the first point is equal to 0, 0, and this is equal to each side is also given by 1 meter, and this is also 1 meter. And the coordinates is the same. X coordinate 1, y coordinate is 0, 1, 0. If the coordinates of the same, the perpendicular line of the same. This is the x coordinate and this is the y coordinate. X coordinate means in the half. మొత్తం 1 అనుకుంటే ఎంత అవుతుంది 1/8 కామా అండ్ y కోఆర్డినేట్ మీన్స్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద హైట్ హైట్ షుడ్ బి ఈక్వల్ టు y కోఆర్డినేట్ హైట్ ఆఫ్ ద కార్టర్ ట్రయాంగిల్ ఇస్ √3/2 l ఇస్ ఆల్సో ఫర్ 2 కాబట్టి దిస్ ఇస్ √3/2 సో జస్ట్ వేర్ హావ్ ఆ m1 m2 m3 కోఆర్డినేట్ దెన్ కోఆర్డినేట్ ఆఫ్ ది సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ మాస్ ఇస్ గివెన్ బై x cm ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు పడల పాత m1 x1 ప్లస్ m2 x2 plus m3 x3 by m1 plus m2 plus m3. Come on. What is m1? 1. x1 is 0. m2 is equal to 2. x2 is equal to 1. Plus m3 is equal to 3. And x3 is equal to 1/2. Okay. By m1 plus m2 plus m3 is equal. 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equal to 6. This is, it is 0. 2. Plus 3/2. 2 plus 3 by 2 is 2 plus 3 by 2 by 5. But 2 LCM is 4, 4 plus 3 is 7 by 10. 2 into 5 is 10. 7 by 10. This is XCM. Similarly, YCM is equal to 4 by 2. m1y1 plus m2y2 plus m3y3 by m1 plus m2 plus m3 is equal to m1y1 0, here y coordinate 0. If you have a second coordinate, y coordinate 0, plus 0 plus m3 is equal to 3 into y3 is equal to 239 by m1 plus m2 plus m3 is equal to 5. So that is 3 root 3 by 10. 3 root 3 by 10. These are the x-ray and also y-ray. Okay, here, find the distance. Center of mass and coordinates x-ray and y-ray. Then you see, what is the distance of center of mass from the one of the corner? This is suppose r is equal to 10,000. The coordinate 0,0, the x-ray and y-ray. Then the distance of center of mass from one of the corner is given by r is equal to root of xcm square plus ycm square. This is the distance final question. Okay? This is one method. But while solving this method, we are having this formula. These are the coordinates of center of mass, xcm, ycm, and also zcm. It is xcm formula, ycm formula, zcm is also equal to m1 plus m2 plus m2 plus m1 by capital. Right? This is one method. Next example 2. Suppose four particles having identical mass each are having m. They are arranged at the corners of a parallelogram of side length a comma b. Find the coordinates of the center of the circle. So this is a parallelogram. This side is equal to A and this side is equal to B. Angle between these two sides is equal to is given by A. Again, at the four corners, four identical masses are kept here. Here the mass is M. This is also M. M and M. Okay, to find the coordinates of center of mass, suppose the center of mass point. Let us imagine one coordinate system. This is x direction, now this is y. This is the frame of reference. Okay, on coordinate system. Let us write out the coordinates of m. Okay, what are the coordinates? 0, 0. And here coordinates are different. X coordinate a, y coordinate is 0. But to find the coordinates of third body and also fourth body, let us draw a perpendicular line onto x axis. Here I indicate this way. Here b will be divided into two components. Along the margin and diagonal, b component is equal to b cos theta and this is equal to b sin theta. Similarly, from this point also, let us draw a perpendicular line on x axis. Okay? This is angle theta. It is also equal to b line because this pattern is this. The component of the along this diagonal, this is equal to b cos theta and this is b sin theta. Now, what are the coordinates of the third body given? We can coordinate this one. X coordinate. The x coordinate is only b cos theta enough. X coordinate b cos theta and y coordinate is equal to b sin theta. B sin theta. And b coordinate of this coordinate should say, this is b cos theta. Okay? Coordinate should be measured from the x-axis of the origin of the coordinate system. From the origin to this point, this is equal to a, and from this point, this is b cos theta. And here the x-coordinate is a plus b cos theta, and y-coordinate becomes b sin theta. So these are the four coordinates corresponding to four particles. Then how we find the xcm, now so by cm. Xcm is equal to m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3 plus m4 x4 because there are four particles here by m1 plus m2 plus m3 plus m4. That is here m is common. What is x1? 0. Plus x2 is a. Plus x3 is equal. B cos theta. Plus x4 is equal.
this is a plus b cos theta by m plus m plus m plus m is equal to 4 m and m cancel, that is equal here a plus a is equal to 2a plus b cos theta plus b cos theta is 2b cos theta by 4. Later this is here two components cancel, they say a plus b cos theta by this is x2 and also ycm is equal here ycm is equal to formula is m1 by 1 plus m2 by 2 plus m3 by 3 plus m4 by 4 by m1 plus m2 plus m3 plus m4 that is equal here m is common into what is y1 y coordinate 0 plus y coordinate for second particle is 0 plus for the third particle b sin theta and plus for fourth part y coordinate is also equal to b sin theta by m1 plus m2 plus m3 plus m4 means 4 m1 and cancel here this is b sin theta plus b sin theta 2b sin theta by 4 2 and 4 cancel out and so this is b sin theta by 2 now the coordinates of m comma 6m comma vcm is equal to what the value a plus b cos theta by 2 comma b sin theta by these are the coordinates of m comma okay right so senior minor students the next concept is shift of center of mass there is an example suppose here it is a square frame of uniform thickness made of same material from the square plate of mass m one quarter plate is removed one quarter of the plate is removed find the shift of center of mass first of all it is a uniform square plate now uniform square plate number 2 center of mass is lying exactly at the center of the square plate okay this is relativity something only okay one part of the square plate is removed can they remove this is very important question each side plate is equal to ఇది కూడా ఇది ఇది మేము కొంది ఇది మనం రాయగలం జస్ట్ ఒక పాయింట్ ఉంది దీనిని రిమూవ్ చేసినట్లయితే ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ రిమూవింగ్ దిస్ వన్ కంపల్సరీ సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ మాస్ విల్ బి షిఫ్టెడ్ టు ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్ బికాజ్ ఆన్ ద సైడ్ దేర్ ఇస్ ఎ వి మాస్ ఇది ఒరిజినల్ సెంటర్ అండ్ దిస్ ఇస్ సేమ్ యాస్ ఫస్ట్ బాడీ ఇది ఫస్ట్ బాడీ ఓన్లీ ఈ వన్ పాయింట్ ఇది సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ మాస్ వచ్చేసి వైస్ ఎట్ దిస్ పాయింట్ బోర్డ్ ఓకే రిమైనింగ్ సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ మాస్ ఓ దగ్గర నుంచి ఇట్ విల్ బి షిఫ్టెడ్ టు ఓ వన్ ఉంటుంది ఓ ఓ వన్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు మనం ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేయాల్సింది దిస్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఆర్ ఆర్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎక్స్ దిస్ ఇస్ అరౌండ్ అండ్ దిస్ ఈస్ ఆర్ ఫార్ములా ఉంటుంది సపోజ్ చూడండి టోటల్ మాస్ ఆఫ్ ది స్క్వేర్ ప్లేట్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఆర్ మాస్ ఆఫ్ ది రిమూవ్డ్ పోర్షన్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు m కోర్ మాస్ ఆఫ్ ది రిమైనింగ్ కాన్స్టెంట్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు m అనుకుంటే ఎంత అవుతుంది m2 m ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు m / 4 మాస్ ఆఫ్ ది రిమూవ్డ్ పోర్షన్ m3 ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు m / 5 రైట్ ఓన్లీ 1/4 ఇస్ రిమూవ్ రిమూవ్డ్ మాస్ ఇస్ సేమ్ m2 బట్ m3 ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు m / 4 రిమైనింగ్ మాస్ ఇస్ m / 5 ఓకే అండ్ ఫర్ కంపల్సరీ మాస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ టు పీసెస్ ఇస్ లైసెన్స్ If this one is removed, compulsory center of mass shifted to bottom. Okay, right? So, about the original center, about the original center of mass, about the original center of mass, you know, m1 r1 is equal to m2 r. m1 r1 is equal to m2 r. What is the one here? 3m by 4 into r is equal to r is equal to x this is the unknown value one was value m3 is equal to m by 4 into and r is equal to मोतम एल दी हाफ इज इक्वल एल बाय टू दिस इज एल बाय टू दिस इज एल एंड दिस इज
from this uniform circular disc, a small portion having a radius small r
let us remove a smaller portion having smaller than a smaller. Then find the shift of center of mass. It is the question. So this is the original center. Suppose this is the center of the removed portion. Let us smaller is equal to radius of the removed portion. Compulsory center of mass will be shifted to opposite side at which we are moving the mass. So here, this is from the diagram. This is our input x, this is unknown value, that is also called shift of center of mass. Also, it is when the smaller portion is removed at a distance r2 is equal to a. A is the known value. So, r equal to x, r2 is equal to a. Then, about the center of mass, you know, the original center of mass, m1, r1 equal to r2, r. But what are the values of m1 and m2? In case of circular frame or circular disk, mass is directly proportional to area. That's why you can written as m1, mass of the remaining one, m2 is equal to mass of the removed portion. Therefore, m2 is directly proportional to its area. Area is equal to pi r square. M1 is equal to, if the mass of the remaining portion is from the total area, we can remove the smaller area, that means pi into cap r square minus r square. Okay, so about the original center, m1 r2 m2 r2, m1 is replaced by pi into capital r square plus small r square. Right, about the original center of mass, m1 r2 m2 r2, m1 this value, m2 pi into small r square into r2 is replaced by a. Therefore, both is pi by cancel. Now, shift of center of mass is given by x is equal to r square into a by cap r square minus r square. Okay, so this is the formula for shift of center of mass. When from a larger circular disk of radius capital R, we will remove a smaller portion of radius r, then shift of center of mass is equal to, this is the formula. Right, suppose in the same situation, if the smaller portion is removed from one edge, the smaller disk is removed from one edge, then shift of center of mass is given by, from one edge means this is the required diagram. Okay, it is a smaller circular disk whose radius is equal to smaller. Original center no, center of mass is equal to shift of center of mass from O1, O2, O1. Right here, this is A, you know, from the diagram of value of A, here, this is equal to kappa, and this is small r. Now, small a is equal to kappa plus small r. Okay? Now, x is equal to r square by kappa square plus r square into A is replaced by capital R by small. Therefore, capital R by small means here, capital R by small means A square plus B square, A plus B into A minus B. R plus R into R minus R, R minus R minus R cancel. Therefore, X is equal to R square by capital R by small. Well, in the name, suppose small R is also equal to R by 2. Small R is equal to R by 2 I K. Shift of center of mass is given by capital R square by 4 plus R plus R by 2, that is R square by 4 by the LCM is 2, 2R plus 3, 3R by 2, that is R square by 4 into 2 by 3R. R square cancel 2 ones and 2 twos. Therefore, X is equal to R by 6. So, the shift of center of mass is equal to R by 6. It is faster A. 2010 MCQ. So these are some basic concepts about shift of center of mass. So in the next class I will explain some more concepts regarding the same center of mass. Okay, thank you.